Solving an equation that involves fractions, lesson 7.2a. To solve an equation with the variable on both sides that involves fractions, we start by eliminating the fractions from the equation. Now take a look at this equation. We've solved these before. When we solved this type of equation, we used inverse operations to isolate the variable to one side of the equal sign. And that's basically what we're going to do with these that contain fractions. When the equation involves fractions, we multiply both sides of the equation by the least common multiple of the denominators to eliminate the fractions. So here we had a plus 15, so we did minus 15, the inverse on both sides. That got rid of this as a zero pair, and we're left with 3n is equal to 2n plus 5. Now, we take this 2n from each side, and that's going to create a zero pair here, and we're left with 1n. Remember, we have that invisible 1 in front of the lone variable. We have n is equal to 5. So I'm sure most of you know how to find the least common multiple, but this is just a real quick review, because it may have been a while. The least common multiple, LCM, is the smallest whole number, not zero, that is a multiple of one or more given numbers. So if we have the numbers 4, 6, and 12, we list their multiples, and we find the one that is least that they have in common. So we have 12. So for 4, 6, and 12, the least common multiple is 12. If we have 3, 5, and 6, we list all of their multiples, and we find the multiple that is the least that they have in common. So you can see that 3 and 5 have 15 in common, but 6 doesn't, so we have to keep going. And we find that it's 30. All three numbers have 30 in common. So for 3, 5, and 6, the least common multiple is 30. So here we have the equation 1/4 x plus 2 is equal to 2/5 x minus 1. We determine the least common multiple of the denominators. The denominators 4 and 5. We list their multiples and find out that they have 20 in common. That's going to help us for step 2. Now that we know the least common multiple is 20, we multiply both sides of the equation by that LCM to eliminate the fractions from the equation. We can distribute the 20 to the 1/4 x and to the 2. We're going to get 20/4 x plus 40. And on this side, we distribute it to the 2/5 x and the minus 1, and we get 40/5 x minus 20. We can simplify this to 5x plus 40, and this to 8x minus 20. We multiply the fractions by the 20, by that least common multiple, to increase their values to be whole numbers. Now we've got whole numbers, and we can easily solve the equation. Now for step 3, we use the inverse operations to solve the equation. We see that 20 is less than 40, and it's a minus 20. Since we have minus 20, we can add 20 to each side to eliminate it. We made a zero pair, and now it's gone. And on this side, we have 40 plus 20. That's going to give us a 60. Now we have 5x plus 60 is equal to 8x. Now we subtract 5x from each side. That's going to create a zero pair here, plus 5x minus 5x. It's going to eliminate it, and on this side we're going to have 3x, and the 60 will drop down, so we've got this. And since 3x means 3 times some number x and its multiplication, the inverse operation would be division. So we divide each side by this coefficient 3 to isolate the x to one side of the equal sign. We have 3 over 3, which is really a 1, isn't it? So we have 1x, and 60 divided by 3 is 20. We know x is equal to 20. We use the least common multiple, the LCM, of the denominators to make solving the equation easier. If we used any common multiple, the factors and integer coefficients may be of greater numbers. If we use 60 as a common multiple for 4 and 5, because it is, we could use 60. It's awfully large, though. Now we're going to be multiplying each term by 60, and we're going to get 60 over 4 and 120 over 5. And we're going to be multiplying and adding and subtracting larger values, larger numbers, we'll still get that 20 is equal to x, but by using that least common multiple, we have lesser values that we're dealing with, smaller numbers for our math. Now also keep in mind, when I did it before, I put both of these terms in parentheses and distributed the 20. Well, we can multiply each term by the least common multiple instead of distributing it to each term. I can multiply the 1/4 x by 20, the 2 by 20, the 2/5 x by 20, and the negative 1 by 20. We're still going to get that 20 is equal to x. Now remember, each term of an algebraic expression or equation is separated by a plus or minus symbol. That means we have 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. We're finished with 7.2a. We're going to move on to b, solving an equation that involves decimals. So just keep in mind that you may think distributing that least common multiple to each term might be easier, the way we did it here, or multiplying each term by that least common multiple might be quicker and easier for you. You're going to get the same answer, whichever you think is the easiest way to do it, or whichever way your homework or schoolwork is telling you to do it. Have a wonderful day and join me for 7.2b, the next lesson. Bye.